Welcome back to the Esoform channel and thanks for tuning in. In this particular video I want to explain how you can take an image or a video of an artificial satellite that is currently in orbit around the Earth, and I'm going to focus on Starlink. So without further ado, let's get into the video. So there are a couple of challenges involved when trying to capture an artificial satellite in the night sky. And the first thing is, of course, that these satellites, they orbit the Earth at very high speed. So you need to know at what time for your particular location a satellite will be in the night sky. And then the satellite is, of course, traveling a specific path in the night sky. So you want to point your telescope and your mount towards a specific location in the night sky which intersects with that particular path the satellite is traveling. And there's often a misconception that in space there is no gravity. But at 500 kilometers above the surface of the Earth, where the International Space Station is located and also a lot of the Starlink satellites are located, you need to travel at 7.5 kilometers per second or 28,000 kilometers per hour just to stay in space. If you would travel a little bit slower than that, you will fall back into the atmosphere of the Earth. And the reason for that is that actually the gravity at 500 kilometers above the surface of the Earth is about similar as compared to just standing on Earth. And the only way they can stay in space, those spacecraft, is by traveling at very high speeds. And of course you don't have any resistance in space, so you can actually accelerate to these incredible high speeds to stay in orbit around Earth. I will show you the software and the techniques that I'm using to first of all find out at what particular time and a satellite will be out in the night sky and what particular path it will travel. And then the second thing is, of course, to pinpoint your telescope exactly towards a patch in the night sky that intersects with that particular path, and then you have only a couple of seconds to take an image. So let's get into that right now. So the first thing you need to find out is at what time a specific artificial satellite will be in the night sky for your location. And actually I am using a very useful app, or I think it's useful anyway, and this app is called the ISS Detector. It's available for Android and also iOS. So you can see ISS Detector. Of course, I think it started out by just tracking the International Space Station, but at its current version, this application can also track artificial satellites and give you information on the exact time and the exact location of artificial satellites. So let me just show you. I have added, you can see it in yellow, all the Starlink satellites that I'm interested in imaging to the list. And when I click on one, you can just see what kind of path this specific Starlink satellite will travel. And of course there are a lot of Starlink satellites, so you have to be precise in what kind of satellite you want to image or capture. When you swipe to the right and towards the bottom, you will find a link to this website, Heavens Above. And this, I need this particular information as well. So I need to know the name of the satellite. So in this case, I have to look. This is Starlink satellite number 53. And I need like the exact name of that satellite because I'm going to look for the exact coordinates in Stellarium. So hi folks, let me just quickly show you how you can get accurate information on Starlink satellites into Stellarium. The first important thing you need to check is whether or not you actually have this icon highlighted. So at the bottom of your screen you can click on satellite hints here, this icon. And when it's clicked on, it will show you the position of particular satellites in the sky. The next thing you need to do is to configure your Stellarium to be able to track Starlink satellites in this case. So you click here on configuration window. And usually it opens up in the main tab. So you go to the plugin tab, you click on that, you go to satellites, you click on configure, and then that usually opens up like this. You go to sources here, this tab,
And within sources, you need to add like a link to a web page that shows the information of all the Starlink satellites that you want to track. So in this case, I used this particular website, celestrek.com, NORAD elements, starlink.txt. I will provide links to that. I will provide a link in the description of this video. And just to show you what kind of website this is, you can see here, oh, I'm doing something wrong. You can see here that it contains all the information Stellarium needs to track the Starlink satellites. And you can see that there are already a lot of Starlink satellites out there in low Earth orbit. So you can see here that, this website, I think it updates its information also every time 60 new of these satellites are being launched. Let's not get into that right now. But you can then, of course, add this link by clicking on, typing in this link or copying the link here in this particular box. And then press plus, add a new source. And then you need to be sure that your the box here is checked on. So that's about it. Then you have added all of the information you need in Stellarium. And so how you actually then determine when a satellite will be in the night sky, you can just search for Starlink here. Let's do that. Starlink number 53. So, and then what happened here? I don't know. Let's see, because right now it's daytime. I clicked on some other stuff as well. And yeah, you can just see when this particular satellite will be out there in the night sky. So it's not out there yet. So you can see here all of the orbits. It's simulating the orbit of satellite number 53. Okay, and now I think at about... this is still not high enough for me. So you can see at about 10 o'clock, it's here, I think. Here you can see 2245. You can see that in this case, Starlink 53 will be very high up in the night sky, at least for at my particular location. So that would be great for imaging or capturing that satellite. And then you can just pause Stellarium. And there are a couple of things that you need to write down then. You need to know the exact time to the second where it is, at which this satellite will cross this particular position. So in this case, we have 22, so 10 o'clock at night, or a quarter to 11, so 22:44 minutes and 35 seconds. So you need to write that down, 10 o'clock, 44 minutes, 35 seconds. So then you know the exact time when you want to image the satellite. Now you need the exact location of that particular satellite. And the location is, you can see it here, the RA deck coordinates according to the J2000 system. So the right ascension coordinates are 10 hours, 42 minutes and 17.16 seconds. And the declination coordinates in this case are 55 degrees, 2 arc minutes and 48.8 arc seconds. So you need to write down the RA and DEC coordinates and the time. And then I move on to Sequence Generator Pro, and I will make a new event with this particular RA and DEC coordinates. So let's I will show you how I do that. So I am always using Sequence Generator Pro because Sequence Generator Pro has a plate solving option. And the plate solving option allows you to really, really be pinpoint accurate in positioning your mount exactly to a particular patch in the night sky that you want to image. And we need to be very accurate if we want to actually get this satellite into the narrow field of view. So I know that you can also slew your mount to a particular position using Stellarium, but I'm always noticing that Stellarium is a little bit off in my case, at least. If you don't know what plate solving is, I have some videos on Sequence Generator Pro. I will link to that in the description below this video, where you can find out how to set up plate solving and how to set up your gear using this program. What you can do then is to go to File and New Sequence. So this is maybe a little bit advanced. This is maybe for people who already know how to use Sequence Generator Pro. But anyway, so you can see this is will be your new sequence, and you can then create a new target, and you can click on settings. So we are interested in imaging satellite Starlink number 53, and we also know the particular time. So what did we find out? So 22 hours, 44 minutes, and 35 seconds. So let's add that. So at 10:44:35, this satellite will pass at a particular location in the night sky. So now we know the time, and then I am adding the RA and DEC coordinates. So let's find that out again. So Stellarium shows that the RA coordinates are 10:42:17.16. So 10 hours, 44 minutes, and what did I say, 17.6? Yeah, 17.16 seconds. And the declination coordinates are 55:02:48.8. So 55:02:48.8. And always check this. So 10:42:17.6, 10:44:17.16, yes, 52:48.8. So okay, you can see now that I have added the RA and DEC coordinates. So Stellarium know where I want to locate my mount and my telescope. And the thing you also need to check on is then SLU and center on location once you start imaging. And then, of course, you can also create an imaging session. So a light frame, an LPS frame. Maybe you want a 60-second exposure. Maybe you want to take a couple of pictures. How to make exactly a sequence. I will refer to other videos in the description below where you can find out how exactly Sequence Generator Pro works. But this is the information Sequence Generator Pro needs. And then I can actually connect my gear and then start this sequence by clicking on Run Sequence. And then the mount and the telescope will slew to that particular position in the night sky. And it will use plate solving to actually center on that particular location. And then, of course, I'm also using PHD2 guiding to accurately track that particular position in the night sky. So, that's all. And of course, it then depends. Do you want like a long exposure picture where you can see like the streak of the satellite across your field of view? Or do you want a video? So I'm also often using SharpCap. So once I'm centered on that particular patch in the night sky, I'm often using SharpCap also to make a video of a particular particular object, in this case, an artificial satellite.